So friends, let us start with today's topic. It is cure. We are going to know and learn about the cure, whether it is a dream or it is a something that can be achieved. So pure dream or destinations, homeopathic perspective. Friends, when we have entered into the medicines, as we have taken admission in our medical colleges, the biggest questions before us whether what we are going to do, what we have to do, and the answer was only that we have to cure the people. And now when we are in the clinic and seated with the among the patients, and we are also being asked, sir, whether my disease is going to be cured or not. Many a time we give, say yes, many times we say maybe, or sometimes we get disappointed if doesn't happen. So between happening, getting cured and not getting cured, so many big questions are associated, and we have to understand basically what the theme or principles lie behind the word cure. The search for cure, when you look into the history of medicine, the development of prevention and treatment of disease from the prehistoric and ancient time to the 21st century, the present century, the same question is still persisting. So, the disease and treatment. Disease and treatment. That means the life is associated with the disease. That means health and disease, they are the inseparable part of our life. They cannot be removed. Health or disease, they cannot be removed from our life. So, let us see when we are diseased and when we are healthy. When we are between them, we have to answer the cure. The cure, and it is the final destination for the medical science and art. Everyone is wondering and finding out or are in the search of the cure. Whether, and the entire history of the chemistry, entire history of the medical science, and entire history of the physical science, everything is targeted towards the search for the panacea for the getting relieved from the cure for pain is in the pain. We have the what we have understood about the cure. We have tried to understand about the pain, and we for that efforts have been made. So biggest question is that is the pain and pain to relieve get relieved of the pain, we have the pain. Cure sometimes treat. Cure sometimes treat and often comfort always. Sometimes we are treating and sometimes the patient are getting relieved. But whenever we are going seated with the patient, every time the patient has got some relief, comfort. Whether he is getting cured or not doesn't matter. But the experience says that the patient feels comfortable when he comes close to the doctor. Because with the doctor, we find that something is going to happen, some change is going to happen in our life. And this experience gives us a great comfort, great relaxation, and the peace of the mind. So, just before the cure, there is a word comfort, there is a word panacea, there is a word relief. And where you feel something. So hope. Hope is the biggest thing that gives you a desire to get cured. The question is not how to get cured, but how we live with the cure. The question is not that how to get cured. Patient don't want Whether homeopathy, allopathy, Ayurveda, no, but I have to leave thought. I have to leave. I have to survive. So this is the biggest things that we have. So changes is the only constant. Now, why we think about the cure? Because the healthy state is converted into the change, into the disease, and disease is getting, has to be reversed back. What is the change? And what about the change? Change is the process of the life. Change is the process of the life. You see the leaves here, the green leaves. And as it grows, as it comes, starts, it has, it, and as it grows, it keeps on changing from green to the light green to the yellow, and ultimately it gets dried up, or then it vanishes from the earth. So it is a continuous process. What we have to do? Why we think about the cure? We are thinking about reversing the changing process. Reversing the process, changing process. From childhood, we are becoming the adult. And from adult, we are becoming the old. Now, what we desire to become young as possible. So it is going back into the past, going back, acquiring those positions which where we have the, where we were comfortable. Whenever we think nowadays at this age, we think about the childhood, how happy we were. Can we become a child now? Is it possible to become a child now? This is one of the biggest questions that keep haunting in all of the mind of all of us. So every next day is another chance to change your life. Every next day, the coming day means now that something will be there and there is a change. So what type of the change you want? The change that goes of its own, or the change that you want to, according to your mind? So two types of the change we witness. The change which is continuous process, which keep on changing, and change means, for the change will mean, what I want to get changed. I'm cure. It is a noun word. And it means healing or restoring to the health. This word, it comes from, it is not cure, just pronunciation is the cure. It is a noun. It means healing or restoring to the health through the remedy. Origin of the word cure, how it started. In Latin, the noun cura, C-U-R-A, cura, has the general sense the care, to help, support, concern, or attention given to something or someone. When we have a concern, when we take care, when we give attention, that is called cura. It might refer to medical care or healing. Christians use the word deeply in regard to the care of the soul, since that was one of the main concerns. The word passed into the French as cure, and then into the English with the spiritual sense. The English noun curate means one who takes care or soul, a member of clergy developed from this sense. The latter, the medical sense of cure, become the more common. So it is a journey from cura to care and to cure and curate. It is the biggest journey where we started with thinking. No, nobody thought about getting cured. They thought about taking care, having concern. Someone should be there to help me. Someone should be there to support us. And this word etymology for English word, it is borrowed from Spanish, which means attention, efforts, care, responsibility, spirituality, charges, medical treatment, and remedy. And Latin, borrowed from the medieval Latin, it also means the same meaning, repair, attention, change. And where is that, where is getting relieved? Latin, worry, care, attention, solicitude, and treatment. And Indo-European, is attend to. So basically, it is related to paying attention to the patient. Whether it is getting the relief or not, but paying attention is effective. Whether it is a substance or procedure. So now we have to think that what is cure? So cure is a substance or procedure. It is a substance. The procedure ends in a medical condition. And medication and surgical operation changes the lifestyle or even the philosophical mindset that helps end a person's suffering. It is a process where you try to relieve the suffering of the patient. When you want to make a full stop or end the patient's problem. So it may be through the physical process, it may be the change in the lifestyle, it may be the philosophical mindset. Whatever way you process, you adopt, that constitutes the substance for the cure. There are various other terms related, response, a partial reduction in the symptoms after treatment, of health or functioning, prevention, a way to avoid an injury, sickness, disability, or disease in the first place, or therapy, it is a treatment with a problem and may or may not lead to a cure. And healing, it is the process of restoration of health from an unbalanced disease, damage, or unvitalized organism. So response, recovery, prevention, therapy, and healing are the terms which are very much related to our word cure. Now, the two things are very important to understand, cure and healing. Healing and cure are inherently different. Cure means eliminating all evidences of the disease. Healing means becoming whole. Healing means the complete, and cure means removing. So the two different meanings. Cure is the only lasting when healing happens on a deeper level. So when you get the cure, cure will happen only. So healing and cure are related to each other. A cure signifies the banishment of physical illness, removal of the physical illness, but healing could be just a physical cure, but repairing and strengthening of the mind and the spirit. So, suppose your pain is there and it is relieved, you can say that it is cured. But healing means, along with the pain, your mind should also become happy, your strength should improve, your energy levels should improve. So physical, mental, and every place, you become back to become the whole that is called the cure. Cure, WHO, now, WHO defines the cure as, according as a complete state of physical, mental, and social well-being, and not merely absence of the disease or infirmity. When an individual is claimed to be healthy, it is considered the entire being is in a state of wellness and not merely absence of pathogens acting against one physical being. So it is not simply removal of the pathology. It is coming back to the normal state of the mind. Curable and incurable. Now it became an obsolete term. Whether disease is curable or not curable. Symptoms are becoming very vague. When individual experience disease, there is always a tendency to think about being curable or incurable. And when we talk of curing, we talk of the restoration of health by eliminating the symptoms that characterize the disease. And healing, on the other hand, calls for restoration of wholeness. Healing is an integrative process that goes beyond the physical, but also includes mental, emotional, and spiritual vitality as well. So just get well understood about the objective that it has to be there with the cure. Now, so cure, could it be instant? Could be instant, it can take place instantly. One can be cured, but without healing and the reverse. And healing usually takes time. Healing takes time. So healing is an intensely personal, subjective experience. It's very, the things that you feel. When a patient goes to the doctor, he finds everything normal. Physically normal. His mental state is normal. But what the patient says, doctor, I'm not feeling well. So that means he is not cured. He is not healed. When the patient says, yeah, I am feeling well, in spite of the problem, suppose you are having the problem, but the patient feels happy, the person feels happy, that is a healing problem. So wholeness is important. When you feel you are complete, when a man feels he is complete, nothing is lost. Even if your organs are not there, but the man whose leg is amputated and he feels that, you know, I'm comfortable with my one leg only. He's a happy man, he's a whole man, and he has been healed, happened. So marriage of science and medicine. So it is the things that we think about the science and the medicine. Empowered physicians to intervene in the course of the disease affected. So with the science, we have developed the medicines, and which empowers us to intervene into the course of the disease to affect it, and to prevent illness and to eradicate the disease. And psychological conception of healing involves reordering an individual state of position in the universe. Healing is a process in the service of evolution of the whole, what great, even better and more complex quality. It focuses on social organization, role making, and personal growth. So you are happy within the family, happy within the society, happy within the. Suppose you are not worried about the country. Depends on mind exchange. What is happening to my country? What is happening to my state? What is happening to my village? You are not in a state of this group. You are in a state of the problem. So, sociology of the health encompasses social epidemiology, disease, mental health, disability, and medical health. Sometimes when we are in the society, there is a belief in the society, this is good or this is bad. So biologically it may not be bad, but sociologically it may be. Suppose I have some bad habits and I feel comfortable with that, but the society will say, oh no, this is your bad habit and you are not okay. So sociology, the society finds you unhealthy, but you feel healthy. So this is the difference between the sociology and the individual. So when you have to become a cure, you have to become a cure. But this is on the way that all of us are to the continued critical perspective. The power and struggle between physical and medical knowledge and the medicalization of the world. And interaction. And how individuals and how their body in medication by social concepts of health and illness, and how it affects their body around. So, how you feel about your body, this interaction, how you interact with yourself, with your life, that affects the health and the disease. So social construction of the health involves doctor-patient relationship. The patient is not isolated, doctor is not isolated, they have together be together and look up the health. And the structure of the socio-economic sickness and disease. Both have two terms, sickness and disease. In two senses, they do not convey the same meaning. If sickness is considered a role and illness is form a deviance from the norm, and that disturbs the social function of the society. So, sickness will be the very individual and illness that relates to you with the society also. So being sick is not simply a condition. It contains within itself customary rights and obligations based on the social norms that surround it. So when you are living in a society, in the social norm, and you are able to follow the social norm, you are happy with the social norm, you are happy with the society surrounding, you are in a healthy position. But if you are not comfortable in the society, then you are not in a healthy position. So labeling approach to the health and the disease. Now, nomenclature. Now, this aspect is very important for us, because for everything we want to give a name. What is happening to me, doctor? You have the pain, but what is that? What is the name for that? If you say that migraine, I am suffering from migraine. So nomenclature for every problem is there. So this is labeling approach to the health and the disease. And it claims that mental illness is only viewed as a result of the social influence. And labeling is born out of the majority. So negativity is labeled the minority of those seen and deviate from the standard cultural norm. Labeling is on the very generalized terms. It takes some common consideration and other things are not taken up. So with the labeling, we are limiting our approach to the medicine. When we treat the disease by name of the disease, like migraine, like cancer, we are limiting our approach. But when we don't think about the label of the disease, we have the wide scope and wide range of the symptoms before us. And it is where you will be able to understand the behavior, self-identity, and all other aspects that is there. And with the labeling, what happens? You become a stereotype. The mind works in one direction for you. But when you are not thinking about the name of the disease, you are thinking about the very wide and indifferent aspects also. For many chronic diseases, none of the affecting part patients have a prospect of complete cure, and patients have to learn to live with the disability. Now, there are certain types of the disease where cure is not possible. So now the patient has to learn about living with the disease. So treat appropriately and rarely reoccur. Treated appropriately and rarely reoccur. This is the concept here. And this is also when you are not able to be, suppose something is permanently damaged, in that condition, how healthy you can remain, how that also constitutes the cure. Cure and treatment. Now, the two terms, the term cure means that after medical treatment, the patient no longer has particular conditions anymore. And treatment is a process, cure is a destination. So when a cure can't be cured, disease can't be cured, doctor often use treatment to help control it. So if you are not able to cure, what you are doing, you are treating to control. So that means experience as a physician, mission of the physician, and Hedman has the two approaches. Mission, he has given a mission to the patient. And for him, the target is the ideal cure. So mission of the physician is to reach the ideal cure. So they are both face to face. Experience and observation showed that there was no cure with existing dominating medical system. Now, what Dr. Hahnemann has observed and why he discarded the old medical system, only because he didn't find any cure. Any cure is there. So cure in the dominant school of medicine is an obsolete term. For the other medical system, there is no word cure like that. They say simply resolving the situation. Physician still talk the cure, but really thought to find it. They talk about the cure. Yeah, it can be cured, but they don't get the cure. In the second paragraph of the Organon, Hahnemann gives an adequate and a satisfying definition of the ideal cure expressed in the word cure. We all have a study as a homeopath. The highest ideal of cure is rapid, gentle, and permanent restoration of the health, removal and amputation of the disease in its whole extent in the shortest, most reliable, and most harmless way on easily comprehensible. And this was first time in the medical history. First time in the medical history when such a broad definition about the cure was given. A distinction between the cure and the recovery. outcome of the medical treatment may be either cured or a recovery. To realize the ideal of cure, it is necessary to know the exact meaning of these terms and to be able to discriminate between them. The terms are not synonyms. Cure and recovery are not synonyms. They are two different things. Natural recovery following treatment consisting of mere palliation of symptoms should not be mistaken for the cure. So palliation is not the cure. Palliation is simply some relief. And cure is always a result of art and never brought about nature. So cure doesn't happen of its own. It has to be attempted for. Nature only serves to bring about a recovery under the operation of nature's law. Recovery is a spontaneous return of the patient's health. Recovery means suddenly it gets changed up without any support, without any medication. That is called recovery. And it may happen on the natural way. It can happen accidentally. It may happen in any way. There are the instances. And after the removal, disappearance, or cessation of the exciting cause and occasion of disease or as a result of treatment, it is not directed specifically curative in its nature. Recovery takes place by virtue of the existence of sufficient integrity of organs and inherent power or of reactions of in the patient to overcome the disease producing agency without the aid of homeopathy or healing. Recovery is supported by mental, physical, hygiene, judicious, mechanical, or surgical treatment with required and avoidance of drug use for the psychological effect and by enlightened sanitation. Cure is directly related to the disease. Now, cure is directly related to the disease. Definitions of cure is based upon the right conception of nature of the disease. Disease is an abnormal vital process of changed condition of life, which is inimical to the true development of the individual and tends to organic dissolution. So, organs get dissolved, organ disoriented, disorganized. The standard dictionary defines disease as any departure from failure in or prevention of normal physiological action in the material constitution of physical integrity of the living organism. This definition rightly focuses on attention upon the dynamical aspect of the subject for disease is essentially and primarily a morbid dynamical disturbance of the vital power and dysfunction, resulting in a loss of functional or organic balance. Cure refers to the direct restoration of normal physiological actions by medical art. Direct restoration of normal physiological actions by medical art. Some physiological, mind it, physiological actions, that means, doesn't mean that your locations or structural things have been removed. Cure is not merely removal of the external secondary tangible products of disease, but a restoration of the dynamical balance so that the function of organic are again performed normally and patient is in the state of the health. Disease is maintained perceptibly by sign and symptom, and cure is manifested by the removal of the symptom. If symptoms disappear and the patient is not restored health, strength means either there are some important symptoms of the case has been overlooked. Suppose you but patient is not feeling well, but you can see that that may not be, that means you have not undertaken some important symptoms there. All curable cases present perceptible symptoms, but their discriminant often depends upon the acuteness of the observer. How much you can observe, that only makes you understand about the cure. Cure relates to the case as a whole. Cure refers to the patient is not the sum of symptoms of his disease. If a disease is removed, but others remains, it simply means not cure. Cure means complete restoration to the health. Cure does not come by surgical removal, nor by any local means. Now, this is very important. Suppose some organs are removed, some things are so that doesn't, because even after the surgical operation, the patient do not feel well. After removal or external secondary pathological end product of the disease, such as tumor, infusion, collections of pus, useless organ or dead tissue, inner well-being is not restored. Cure is affected only by dynamical treatment according to fixed principle directed to the primarily function disorder as revealed by the complete symptom picture preceding and accompanying the formation of tangible product of the disease. So it is not only the removal of the primary cause, it is the removal of the primary cause or the secondary cause, but it requires the strengthening of the vital principle. And only dynamic treatment is required. So cure can come only after the dynamic treatment. So if you are able to treat the patient dynamically, then only the cure is possible. So cure always follows a definitive law. See, Dr. Henneman, before Dr. Henneman, there was no definitive principle. Dr. Henneman was the first person who tried to establish a law of the cure. And true cure by medication implies the existence of governing principle or law of cure by medication. So occurrence of accidental cure is a natural provides understanding about requirement to follow the nature's law. Henneman grasped nature's law comprehendingly and made it the basis for the therapeutic method, which he named it homeopathy. So the cure has to be followed as always. For only knowing about the medicine, only reading the materia medica, you are not able to cure. You have to know the principle of the organ and of medicine. You have to know the therapeutic process. You have to know the law, what law are involved in the cure, and what is the toxicity of the disease, and what are the antidotal process. All these aspects needs to be understood properly to have a definitive process for the cure. So cure means cure comes only when a definite law is followed. If you are giving medicines and patient feels better, doesn't mean cure. It is simply a chances. It is simply a instant recovery made by some accidental process. Requirement for cure. Now, what things are required for the cure? Direct application of definite general principle of the therapeutic medicine. The basic thing is required is that you must follow the general principle. An explanation and demonstration by reference to the governing principle. And general, what is the general principle? It's capable of systemic demonstration, not only once, but repeatedly and with variably under it. Stated condition. It is always possible to formulate a method or technique by means of which the principle may be successfully applied to every case within its scope. So when law is there, the law can be applied in a, if you know the formula, you can apply it and you can create as many questions, solve as many problems it may be. So must be individual. It is always the requirement for the cure. It must be individual. It is a tailor-made system. Medicine can never be the ready-made phenomena. So requirement for the cure is it must be individual. A general principle according to which any action takes place is always capable of being individualized. Every individual are distinctly different from the other. No two individuals are alike. We all know. And two system of therapeutics must be able to adapt its basic principle and its remedy to the need of each individual case. There are no cures for disease, no remedy for all cases of the same disease. So cure for disease, there is no cure because there is a cure for the individual. You have to keep in the mind, the disease is not cured, only the individual is cured. So no remedy for the case of the same disease. So suppose you get to understand that this medicine is for that particular disease, you are in a dilemma, you are in a delusion. Cure relates to the individual patient, not to the disease. No two cases of the same disease are exactly alike. And differences of manifestation in symptoms and modality always exist in the individual. It is these differences which gives each case its individual dig and creates the need for an individual remedy. Cure takes place in a definite orderly manner and direct. So there is a law, it follows way and direction of the cure. Normal vital process, cellular organic system begins at the center and proceeds toward. So cure always starts from inside and it goes outside. All energy flow is maintained to follow the definite path, and manner of action also maintained. Action is also maintained. You see, sometimes there are aggravations, accumulations. All these are the path, all these are the way or the roadmap for going to the cure. So life is a centrifugal force. What is life? You know that it is centrifugal force. That means it starts from within and goes outward. The process of life is radiating, externalizing, concentrating, and organizing street matter from above downward. And cure is also have the same, have to follow the principle of the life. So centrifugal force of the life, so cure is also has to follow the centrifugal force. That means from within outward and from inside outside. And this is a centripetal force. Life is centrifugal force and disease is centripetal force. So opposing, obstructing, it goes from outside to the inside. It is an attempt to go from outside to the inside. So it is opposing, obstructing, penetrating towards the center and tendency to disorganize. The progression of all cure disease, your chronic disease is from surface towards the center. From less important organ to the more important organ, from below upward. And curative medicines reinforce the life process, reverse the morbid process, and annihilate the disease. Disease and drug relationship. Signs of the therapeutics or the mode of treatment could indicate a relationship between the drug administered and the disease input. This relationship can be similar, different, antagonistic, and at times identical. Similarly, different, and antagonistic. All these relationships exist are there. And based on these relationships, Hahnemann classified the mode of treatment as homeopathic, heteropathic, allopathic, antipathic, and isopathic, respectively. So rationality is required. You have to be rational. You have to be logical to analyze which of these relationships is ideal in the sense that affects the truth. It was the search or the ultimate truth that landed into the discovery of homeopathy as an effective system of the medicine, where it is followed, it follows the law of the similia, law of the similar. So like your life, by similar thing, a disease is produced and through the application of the life is cured. This is the Hippocratic concept, father of the medicine. By similar things, a disease is produced and through the application of life, it is cured. So like your life. The name homeopathy, coined by its original Dr. Hahnemann, is derived from the Greek word for similar suffering, refers to the life principle of healing, like your life. So no remedy can cure any disease unless it acts upon all the diseased parts, either directly or indirectly. The more similar the symptoms of a drug resembles to the disease, the nearer its vital approach to the disease, and more dynamic actions will come. So dynamic actions is required, and it is the similarity. Number, as many as number of symptoms will become similar, that points and give you the brings you closer to the cure. One organ cannot suffer alone, or more than one cell can suffer by itself. Every disease affects in some way, to some degree, every organ, every tissue, and every molecule of in the body. It is the duty of the physician that first to find out what is in the man that is disorder, and then to restore him to health. And this return to health, which is a perfect cure, is to be accomplished by means that that are mild and are orderly, that follow gently like the life force itself, turning the internal of man into order with fixed principle as is guided by the homeopathic remedy. Dr. Kink has given you the path, search for the problem, defining the problem, and selection of the simulimum will give you the cure. So this is the path that you have to follow, sir, searching, defining, selecting, and the cure. The cure is a journey to reach the destination of the health. Only a mediated mind can understand the medicine. So my medicine is what? Medicine is meditation. Cure within medicine. Medicines are a matter of exploration in mediation way. So art for cure is the hope and object in mirror and glowing in that the appears. So there is a good quotations in Ayurveda. Is a way. Hita hitam sukham sukham ayu tasya hita hitam manam cha tasya yato Ayurveda cha utyate. Ayurveda is the Veda that provides the knowledge of the good, bad, happy and unhappy life. It promotes the non-promoter measurement and nature, and this is homeopathy. Itayu, ahitayu, sukhaya, adukhaya, is prakar chaturvidya, ayu ke hit atha, tata ahit, pat aur apat ayu ka praman, evam sarup jisme ho, vah Ayurveda kaha jata. The cure of man, many diseases are known, the physicians, because they are ignorant of the whole. If you don't know the man as a whole, you may not be able to cure. For the part can never be well unless the whole is well. Until your whole is well, then only you can remain the whole. It was said by the Plato. So thank you very much. And the ultimate message, the samasamam samyati. Samasamam samyati. And try to follow this concept. Try to have a devotional approach towards the medicine that will help you understand homeopathy and the medicine is God. You don't think about the homeopathy, don't think about the medicine. I think only about the cure and the relationship. It is very important understanding for all of us. We have to practice medicine. When we are for practicing medicine, it is very important. So thank you very much for this. And if you have any questions, you can ask me. If you have a question on my email ID, risth@gmail.com or WhatsApp number 94310206. Thank you very much.